بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، أشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا. Welcome, my brothers in Islam, to lesson 143 of العربية بين يديك, book 1, part 1 of the new version. And we actually stopped at the middle of page 82, الصفحة الثانية والثمانون, page 82, my brothers in Islam. وسنستمر إن شاء الله, and we will continue إن شاء الله. فائدة, a benefit, جمعه فوائد, بالهمزة على الكرسي, مثل هنا. فوائد are benefits, with the hamza on the chair, like this. نفي الماضي, negating الماضي, the past tense, يكون بي is with ما. So when we negate the past tense, we use ما. There is another way of negating in the past tense, but this will only make you more confused. Why? Because there are two ways of negating the past tense, by using ma and using lam. But the issue with lam, mim, fatha on the lam, sukun on the mim, the issue with lam is you use it with a present tense verb. And by using lam, you have done two things. You've actually done three things. By using lam, you have negated, you also have changed a present tense verb to a past tense verb in meaning, not in writing, because the apparent, what you see, what is apparent to you is a present tense verb. So you have changed it from the present to the past. And the third thing you have done is you have given it a sukun. That's why lam is called harfu nafyin wa qalbin wa jazmin. And this is something you will study in the green book. So it's a negating letter. وَقَلْبٍ is a changing letter from present to past, and it's a jazmun letter, it gives a sukun. So لَمْ يَدْهَبْ خَالِدٌ لَمْ يَدْهَبْ خَالِدٌ is actually مَا دَهَبَ خَالِدٌ, Khalid didn't go. Okay, مَا أَكَلَ خَالِدٌ is just like لَمْ يَأْكُلْ خَالِدٌ. So لَمْ brings back the present to past, but this is something you will study later on. What is actually important to know here is that when we negate any past tense verb in any form, dahabtu, I went, dahabta, you went, dahaba, he went, dahabat, she went, dahabna, we went, dahaba, they two went, dahabu, waw, alif, they went, masculine plural, dahabna with a short noon without alif, they feminine went. When using negation with anyone, with any type of these past tense verbs, we use ma. Okay, so like I've mentioned before, we use la for present tense, and ma's also used for present tense negating. But for the past tense verbs, we use ma. Okay, so when you go to a primary school student who's just in his first years of learning Arabic in one of the Arabic countries, you say la dahaba, he will say no, ma dahaba, he didn't go. Okay, not la dahaba. Clear? Lahdatun min fadlikum. طيب سأستمر, I will continue إن شاء الله. إذن نفي الماضي, negating the past tense verb, يكون بما. ما ذهبت, I didn't go. ما كتبت, I didn't write. ما سافرت, I didn't travel. ما سافرت خديجة, خديجة didn't travel. Ma raja'tu darsa, I didn't revise the lesson. This is a very bad sentence. Ma raja'tu darsa. Ma raja'tu المفرداتي. ما راجعت المفرداتي. I didn't revise the vocabulary. المفرداتي has a كسرة instead of a فتحة because it has ألف open تا. And ألف open تا is not allowed to have فتحة. This is inshallah in the green book. ونفي المضارع and negating the present tense is with be means with بلا. So with using لا. Okay. لا أذهب I don't go meaning now present. فعل مضارع. لا أكتب I don't write. Okay. أنا لا أسافر I don't travel meaning now. As for in the future لن أسافر that's لام نون and that gives a فتحة to the present tense verb. This is inshallah something you will study in the green book. لن is negating if in the future. Okay. لن أزوره I will not visit him future. ودخول لا and entering la على الماضي on the past tense verb. So and entering the la on the past tense verb على الماضي. As you will see in a bit, I will mention that it's very rare. It's so rare that, like I said, the primary student will stop you there. He will stop you when he hears, "I didn't go la dhahabtu." He will say "ma dhahabtu." So what I've mentioned here. It's nadirun jiddan. Nadirun is rare. Nadirun, rare. Jiddan, very. It's very rare. Okay. Dukhulu la, entering la on the past tense verb, like la dahabtu. Nadirun jiddan. It's very rare. Okay. And there might be some even some conditions by using la in the past tense verb. Okay. So what I would say is just refrain from it for the time being until you become a professional and you master the Arabic language and then you can use it accordingly. وَدُخُولُ مَا and entering مَا عَلَى الْمُضَارِعِ. Okay, so for example, مَا يَذْهَبُ خَالِدٌ Khalid doesn't go. Okay, خَالِدٌ مَا يَأْكُلُ Khalidun is not eating, meaning now. So entering ma on the present tense, ala al-mudari'i ashharu, is more famous than the la on the madi. Okay? Kama fil Qur'ani al-Karim, like in the Noble Qur'an, under Surah Yunus, under Surah Yunus, look to Surah Yunus, al-ayatu al-wahidatu wa-sittuna, the 61st ayah of Surah Yunus, you will see there that the verb is negated, the present tense verb is negated with ma, and like I've mentioned, that is allowed, and nobody will stop you by saying ma yadhabu khalidun, Khalid doesn't go. Okay, khalidun ma yanamu, Khalid's not sleeping. Okay, lakin, but al-ashharu ma'a al-mudari'i istighdamu la. What is more famous for the present tense is using la, no doubt. Clear? Khalidun la yanamu is more famous than Khalidun ma yanamu. Okay? Clear? As for using la in the past tense, you're putting yourself under a question mark and people will stop you. Okay? Khalidun la dahaba. Didn't go, for example. People will stop you because it's not used except for a little bit according to the senior Arabic scholars, but with conditions or there might be conditions, so Allah knows best. طيب ماذا تفعل بعد الصلاة؟ What do you do after the prayer? تفعل فعل مضارع مهم. تفعل is an important present tense verb. مهم, important. تفعل. Just imagine you don't know what the English doing means. How many sentences are you not able to make? Okay? You don't know how to say, you don't know what are you doing means. What are you going to do means. What did you do means. Okay? Past, present, do this. You don't know how to say to somebody do this. So it just shows you in each language the verb doing is so important. هذا فعل مضارع مهم. Important. من الفعل, it comes from the verb. We're going through the derivements inshallah. فعل, فعل is he did. Okay, put this in a question. ضع هذا الفعل في جملة. Put this verb in a sentence. ماذا فعل خالد؟ What did خالد do? إذن فعل as he did. Okay. ماذا, how do you say what did you do? Because the he form past tense is the shortest. Normally three letters. فعل he did. أكل he ate. كتب he wrote. قرأ he read. So how do we use the you form in the past tense? You must learn. ماذا فعلت? What did you do? ماذا فعلت? What did you feminine do? ماذا فعلت يا خالد? إذن فعل he did. المضارع يفعل. Because all of this is luxurious. You know the فعلت. You will not see this in the dictionary. لا ترى هذا في المعجم. You will not see this in the dictionary. In the dictionary, you will see this. فعل, he did, and straight away too, he does. يفعل. As for I did, you did, she did, no. In the proper Arabic dictionary, you will only get the he forms. He form past tense, he form present tense. So I just give you this extra. ماذا فعلت? What did you do? Because according to the dictionary, or those who have written it from long before, all the new dictionaries, they think that you already know that dhahabta is you went, dhahabtu I went, dhahabti you feminine, dhahabna we went, dhahaba they two went, male or female, dual form, dhahabu wow alif, silent alif, written not pronounced, dhahabu they went masculine, plural, dhahabna they feminine went. They already think that you already know that. Why should they put that with each verb? Because it's one style. Any Arabic word, any Arabic verb in the world, give any past tense verb in the world, you have the same pronouns. The ta for you masculine, tu for I, meaning I masculine or feminine. A woman can say dhahabtu and a man can say dhahabtu. There's the I form. There's no difference in gender. Dhahabti you feminine, dhahabna nun alif we went. Dahaba, they two went. Dahabu, they lot. Wow, silent alif. Dahabna, they feminine lot. So, dahabtum, you lot, went masculine. Dahabtunna, with shadda on the noon, is you lot feminine went. So why should they repeat it? You know how big the dictionary will become by mentioning each pronoun with each verb. How many volumes do we need? And that's why we use the style of those who have preceded us, the scholars of the dictionary of the Arabic language, so they use only the he form. إذن فعل he did, يفعل he does. Okay, وأنت وهي, this is all extra information, it's all luxurious. I'm mentioning now the أنت وهي, this is something that you will not find in the dictionary. أنت, you masculine, wahiya and she, they share one verb in the present tense. I've told you this so many times. Anta, you masculine, wahiya, she, they both share this verb, taf'alu. Anta taf'alu, wahiya taf'alu. Khadija tu taf'alu. Okay? So you and she share one verb. Wa anti, as for you feminine, this is also luxurious. This is not mentioned in the dictionary because you should know it. Anti taf'alina. Okay? It's a sukun in the ya. That's what you find here. This is the kasra of anti. It's not a fatha on the ya. Anti taf'alina. You feminine are doing. Mada taf'alina. What do you do to a woman? Mada taf'alu ya khalidu. What do you do for masculine? If'al, do. They will not mention here the pronouns. If'ali with the ya for feminine. Do. Command for a feminine. If'ala, you too, do. Whether two male, one male, or one female, as long as they are two. If'alu, do you lot? Eh? If'alu, if'alu khayran, you lot, do good. واو ان الف ريتن نوت برونونسد. افعلنا يو فيمينين لوت دو، افعلنا هذا دو ذس. المصدر is فعلاً. So normally it's فعلون but they just want to like I've mentioned highlight the two fatha to differentiate between the مصدر and the other nouns like اسم فاعل اسم مفعول. إذن فعلاً is doing لكن this مصدر هذا المصدر نادر الاستعمال. This مصدر is rare in usage. نادر الاستعمال. يعني you might not hear for years the word فعلا. What is the noun used for doing? There is another noun but it's not the مصدر. Although it means doing. وأما كلمة as for the noun as for the verb فعل فعل فأشهر it's more famous than فعل. Okay فعل أشهر من فعل. So when we put فعل and فعل then definitely فعل is more famous and فعل means doing. وليس the word فعل ليس مصدرا لهذا الفعل. So فعل ليس مصدرا it's not a مصدر لهذا الفعل of this verb فعل. ومعناه the meaning of the word فعل is an act is a deed. هذا فعل حسن this is a good deed it's a good act. Okay and it also means doing or acting. Oh yeah and the word فعل also means a verb. فعل مضارع is present tense verb. فعل ماض to كسرس past tense verb. فعل أمر is a command verb. والجمع أفعال verbs deeds acts. بهمسة القطع أفعال. أما اسم الفاعل as for the اسم فاعل فهو فاعل. It's the doer the one that does something. فاعل and a فاعل also means a subject. We have فعل verb فاعل subject مفعول به object. والمفعول مفعول done performed. Okay هذا العمل this work مفعول is done performed قبل يومين two days ago. مفعول also means effectiveness effect. سأعطيكم مثالا I will give you an example إن شاء الله. هذا الدواء this medicine دواء is medicine without L it gets to dhamma دواء medicine والجمع أدوية as you will get in book, the green book إن شاء الله medicines تال مربوطة همزة القطع. هذا الدواء ليس له مفعول. This medicine has no effectiveness has no effect. Okay مفعوله قوي its effect is strong. Okay نعم إذن ماذا تفعل بعد الصلاة؟ What do you do after the prayer؟ أقرأ القرآن. I read the Quran. ومتى تذهب إلى المدرسة؟ And when do you go to the school؟ And you don't have to translate L always as the. So when do you go to school؟ Okay. Okay, why don't we just drop the N and say ومتى تذهب إلى مدرسة؟ I would not do it because if you say to an Arabic person ومتى تذهب إلى مدرسة it means and when do you go to a school. You see how it sounds? And when do you go to a school? So how can we get the English sentence, and how do, and when do you go to school? Then you have to put the L, okay? And when do you go to school? ومتى تذهب إلى المدرسة؟ إذن متى is when. As for at which time, who knows? من منكم يعرف? Who of you lot knows? At which time do you go to school? At what time do you go to school? فمعناه its meaning is في أي وقت. And this is علامة الحذف. It's a sign of deletion. Meaning not to mention the whole sentence. But the whole sentence will be في أي وقت. And the kasra should be above the shadda. أي means which. And here it becomes أي because it's ismu. اسم مجرور. The noun affected by في. في أي وقت, at which time. في أي وقت تذهب إلى المدرسة. At which time do you go to school. Or just say متى, when. It's quicker. It's just one word instead of three. متى, when. متى is always fixed on the alif. You will not see متي or متو. It's always متى, when. Fixed, مبنيون, fixed, unchangeable. ومتى تذهب إلى المدرسة, and when do you go to school. تذهب is you masculine goes, and it can also be she because the you masculine and she always share the same verb. إذن so أنت تذهب, you go, وهي تذهب and she goes. هذا الفعل ومشتقاته, this verb meaning the verb تذهب and its past tense ذهب. This هذا الفعل, this verb ذهب ومشتقاته and its derivations مهمة أيضا, is very is important also. وقد تناولناها, and we have gone through it. Okay, تناولناها literally means we've consumed it, but in the context of studying it means we have gone through it. Okay, تناولنا هذا الموضوع, we have gone through this topic or subject. إذن so I will not repeat the ذهب, يذهب, اذهب and its derivements ذهابا. So I've repeated it. فهو ذاهب, والمفعول مذهوب or مذهوب إليه. You can double check the notes. This is the place where you go to. مذهوب إليه والله أعلم. ذاهب is the goer. ذهاب is going. إذن so ومتى تذهب إلى المدرسة, normally it's what, مدرسة. If you drop the إلى, what made what gave a كسرة to المدرسة, to the school, because of إلى, إلى المدرسة with one ضمة because of L, L never goes with two ضمة, becomes إلى المدرسة. إذن normally it's عادة, you will find هذا هو الأصل, this is the root, مدرسة to ضمة. الجمع, what's the plural of مدرسة, ما جمع مدرسة, الجمع مدارس. مدارس ممنوع من الصرف. You can see the صاد meaning it has one ضمة because it has the same pattern of مساجد, مفاتيح, masks, keys. Okay, مواعيد, appointments. Plural of موعد, appointment. إذن مدارس are schools. سواء whether these schools are ابتدائية, they're primary schools, أو سواء الابتدائية, whether it's the primary school, أو المتوسطة, or the secondary school, أو الثانوية. As you know, this should be a ya. And that is, of course, obvious. This should be a ya here, not a alif maqsura. الثانوية, don't forget the shadda on the ya, and a fatha. What is college? And all these stages, you will study them in the green book, and they will even add stages like the nursery, and they will add the university, and they will add masters and PhD. All of that you will study, inshallah, in a very crystal clear jadwalun table. They will give you all these levels and the ages in these levels. This all something, all what you will study, inshallah, in the green book. Then, so if I say al-madrasatu thanawiyatu is the college, al-madrasatu al-mutawassitatu is the secondary school, al-madrasatu al-ibtida'iyatu is the primary school. And so many times you find these big banners in front of these big buildings, you will see that al-madrasatu al-ibtida'iyatu, what shows or what means it is the primary school. على كل حال, anyway. والمدرسة, the word المدرسة, in some of the countries, when you say to somebody, I'm studying in a madrasa, for example, in Asia, when you go to, for example, to Pakistan, what means the word مدرسة? They're using the same word, okay? They say مدرسة, and it's an Arabic word. But what they mean with madrasa is different than what is meant in the Arabic language. So al-madrasa to the school fi Pakistana, it's normally Pakistanu, but because of fi, one dhamma becomes a fatha. The word madrasatun fi Pakistana ta'ni, it means al-madrasa to diniyatu, the religious school. That's what they mean with madrasa in Pakistan. Allati yuhfadu fiha al-Qur'anu, wherein the Quran is memorized. Okay, wa hiya tusamma fi al-lughati al-arabiyya, and it's called in the Arabic language, meaning the religious school, the Quranic school, is called in the Arabic language kuttabun, with the shadda on the ta. Okay, kuttabun with the shadda on the ta. And even if you don't put any harakat, an Arabic person will not read it as kitabun, because the context. It's true that if you remove all the harakat and the shadda, it just looks like kitabun, book. But the Arabic person will know if you say adrusu fil kuttabi, I'm studying in the Quranic school. He will not say adrusu fil kitabi, I study in the book. He will know that it means al kuttabi with a dhamma on the kaf and a shadda on the ta. Then kuttabun is Quranic school in the Arabic language, and al-jam'u katatibu. And this word kuttabun was very famous before all these universities came, and these primary schools and these other schools, this nowadays terms. In the past, every child used to start in the kuttabun. Okay, and the first thing he memorizes is the Quran, and then from then on, we will see. He can learn a profession, he can learn occupation, etc. Then, kuttabun is a Quranic school in the Arabic language. والجمع كتاتيب ممنوع من الصرف. Wahia, in some of the countries like Mauritania, they have a specific name for a Quranic school. Okay, wahia fi Mauritania, it's one of the Arabic countries in West Africa. In Mauritania, the Quranic school is called Mahdaratun. As some of you already know, Mahdaratun is a Quranic school. والجمع محاضر ممنوع من الصرف. Like I said, مساجد, anything that has any word that has the pattern of مفاعل will get one dhamma. مساجد مفاتح. سأقف هنا إن شاء الله, وإلى درس قادم إن شاء الله. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, استغفرك وأتوب إليك. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.